Talking about the environmental economy theory, the main question is why people do what they do. Why people do all the activities? Why they get up? If I could ask you, why do you get up? Why do you eat breakfast? Why do you go to school, work, everywhere? Why do you go to the market? Why do you go to visit your family or friends? And so on, so on. So if we think about this, why we do all those activities since morning till evening, and even the question why we sleep, the answer is, of course, because we need it, yes? Why we eat breakfast? Because we are hungry. Why we go to the market? Because we need some goods, foods, and so on. So all what is the engine of our activities all the time in our life, those are our needs. Yes, they are the reason, the beginning and the end of all our activities like a people. Okay, so we all need something. And if we ask, what is the one characteristic, one word we can use to characterize the needs, how they are, the needs. So my question is, do you have any time, the situation that you could say, now I don't need anything, now I have everything, now I'm totally satisfied? If so, that's good. Yes, I think maybe you have this situation, this state, but in a moment, how long? An hour or even no? I don't know, when you were after a good meal or, I don't know, watching this beautiful sunset, you could say, oh, now I have everything. It's so fantastic that I don't need anything more. But it was the long-term state of mind? Rather no. Yes, even we are hungry, we eat something and then we are hungry again about after 2 hours. So all the needs are never ends and unstoppable and repeatable. Those biological needs are all the time, again and again, we need to act to fulfill them again. They are only satisfied for a short time. Other needs, like this higher needs, when we satisfied one, for example, we have one stage of education or some level of income, then we have more, then we want to have more, yes? So the needs are actually never ends, and to satisfy them, it's only the moment to satisfy it. And again, when one need is satisfied, another replace the satisfied need. So we all permanent, we want something like a people. And so that's the one side of the problem, yes? From the another side, the answer, what we use to satisfy our needs, what we need to satisfy our needs. Those are, of course, all kinds of resources. So when we are hungry, we need food. When we are tired, we need a place to sleep or sleep, yes? When we are cold or want to good look, we need some clothes or any specific clothes. When we want to see the movie, we need the entertainment. We need to this entertainment and also the information. Yes, where is the movie, where they play the movie we want to see, and so on and so on. So all those kind of resources are needed to satisfy our needs. And those are also the physical goods, but also services, time. It's a very important need, resource, information, and also all the kind of natural resources which we need to satisfy our needs. And if you would like to characterize resources using one word, one characteristic, what we can think about the every kind of resource. The best practice to imagine this, what I mean, please think about the money you have in your pocket. If you think about your money, what is your first connection in your mind? Of course, I don't know exactly how it's in your culture, but here in Poland, in Europe, everyone, if you ask him, what do you think about your money? Oh, they're not enough. There could be more. Too less. Yes. I don't have money at all. And so on. And that's the same with all kind of resources, actually. What we say, not only that we don't have enough money, but also we don't have enough time. We don't have enough time for all those activities we do during the day, during the week. For example, I didn't know about something, so we didn't have enough information. Here in Poland, there are the time with the winter time when we really miss the sun, for example. The sun, of course, is still on the sky in a space, but here we cannot use it. Yes, we cannot satisfy this need of sunshine day. So we can say that all the resources are finished. In a particular place, in particular time, they are not enough. They are, we call in economics that they are rare. All the resources are rare. And what does it mean? What is the... and then what is the what's happened with this? That from the one side we have the never unstoppable never end needs, more and more needs we have, and from the other side what we need, only way to satisfy our needs are the resources which are finished and rare. And that's why we, as a people, all the time, we faced the problem, the decision problem, because we have to choose. All the time, we are in front of the choosing situation. How to spend our money? What is more important at this moment? How to spend our free time? How to spend our time with friends? Yes, how to, what to buy, to what kind of clothes to buy, and so on and so on. We all the time, what to eat for breakfast? Yes, what to eat, what to buy, and so on. So all the time we are in the situation of this making decision, and how we make this decision, what is our role in making decisions, in choosing how to use the resources, the shortened resources we have. We try to follow this economic efficiency rule. So we try to gain as much as possible, so the most benefit to have from every decision, paying engage the less cost. Of course, in economics, it doesn't have to be only the money. We don't have to count those benefits and costs in money. Not, it's not necessary, yes? All the benefits, it's a level of satisfying the needs. So are you, we want to be the most satisfied? This need, we want to satisfy, fulfill the needs in 100%, but using the less resources is possible. Then we have this the most economic efficiency. And of course, it's also the biological rule, because even our brain works in the same, that it uses as less energy as is needed to satisfy our body needs. So it's something very natural that we try to gain this economic efficiency. It's nothing wrong. It's natural. So the question is, what's wrong? What is wrong with the economics? Why it causes so many problems? Why we said the economy nowadays, it's a huge problem in this sustainable development goals and so on. Why? If it's so natural, so what is the problem? The problem is that the people have to rival for the resources. When they rival, and this rivalization is not only in the market, but because there is not enough resources, when we have to somehow fight for the resources, in every fight can be some losers also. So that's the one problem. And the second problem is that on the market, the resources are not allocated in a proper way, not every resources. So we call it market failure. The economical classic people thought that economic have this system. The market mechanism is so ideal that it's enough for proper resources location. So the so people thought that market mechanism can allocate resources in a proper way. Who needs, who can pay it, get, and only those people who need some resources, they get it. But we know nowadays that it's not true. So all the time people are in front of this problem, trade-off problem. We always have to decide, produce or buy or make. Buy this or this, how to satisfy, the need, how to do it. All the time this problem, all the time the situation to choose between options. Second, those are the externalities. So externalities are not seen by the market. So those are not in this calculation of economic efficiency. And because externalities appear in economy, this improper allocation of resources also appear. But we know that in the sustainable development rule is that the resources should be reallocated to make at least one person better off without making anyone else worse off. Yes, and it's also related to environment, social and economical problems. So somehow we should search for the solution for the situation, like win-win situation in this rival, in this fighting, and also compromise in trade of problem. So let's focus on the externalities. Why they make the market failure? Externalities, we can talk about the we will talk only about the externalities connected with the environmental and also social life, but in meaning of the quality of life. So externalities which influence the environment and the quality of life. And of course we have some positive externalities. But what is more important in our topics and what is the problem. Those are those negative externalities. Externalities, those are this phenomena which are not in the calculation of economic efficiency, which this all the calculation system cannot see them. So they don't took part in a reducing cost and gaining the most, the highest beneficial. Why it's so? Those externalities connected with the environmental are because the environment components were up to now seen like common goods or public good. Common good, so everyone has the same access to all the components of the environment and can use it like a free good, by free. As long as people can don't have to pay for the components of environment, they cannot use it in the calculation of economic efficiency, in this cost-benefit calculation. So as long as the components of the environment are the like free goods, totally we can have the access without any paying for it, effort or money, they are not included in the economic efficiency calculation, and that's why there is no any need to reduce them like a cost. When we don't treat them like a cost, we don't need to naturally. We don't try even to reduce these costs. We will focus especially on those externalities connected to transport, because transport is very huge part of the every economy. Every economy, a lot of depends on transportation sector, but also transportation sector is one of the most environmental influence. Yes, so there are a lot of externalities, these negative externalities connected to the transport. Of course, all the pollutions, but not only, and noise, but not only, but also the accidents, the congestions, the infrastructure damage, and so on, influence very much to the environment, resources, components, and also quality of life. So as long as people treat the components of the environment like a free goods, like a good for free, they don't put it in the calculation of the economic efficiency, and they don't try to reduce using those components for better gain. So that's the conclusion that we should change those externalities to the internalities. So somehow to put into the calculation. And the next section of my lecture is about the ideas, how to put those externalities, so the environmental components, to the calculations of economics efficiency.